Dear Father in heaven, we come to thee this morning, Lord. As we're about to begin with our lessons, we pray, Father, that our minds may be open and that we may hear you clearly speaking to our hearts. We pray that your Holy Spirit may abide with us and that we may be convicted, Father, to do as thy word tells us to do, Lord. We ask all of this in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I don't know if you guys noticed that yesterday in the group, Sister Naomi posted a screenshot of one of the lectures that that the Saved to Serve ministry is doing. Hilary Henriquez is doing a series, and I hope, and I'm asking the church to really go through it. It's very interesting, not for females only, but it also covers a lot for the males as well. She's on the 10th series now, on the 10th lesson, and she's showing us, even in exercising, how we ought to dress. So my lesson today, I found this very interesting, and it's quite lengthy, but it's just mostly pictures, and I would like to ask the church, and that we interact, but it's going to... The 15 minutes that I have is going to go faster if we interact. So I will read and I will ask for the first thing to keep moving along. And then I ask you to please look at the pictures.
Okay.
Amen. Let's open our Bibles, Revelation 3, verse 17.
Revelation 3, verse 17.
So this is basically about modesty. This series that I'm asking you to go through, I'll share the link in the group. It's basically about modesty. So we're still looking, I'm going to go into a bit of that, but I would like us to look at these pictures because, it was very eye-opening to me. It was shocking when I saw this.
Revelation chapter 3, verse
17. Can someone please read it for us in Swati and in English?
Okay. Swati?
Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked.
Amen.
So, please go to page 2. Yes. Today I would like to consider a popular practice that has brought the members of God's church into a near naked state, which is swimming. There is a strange idea that somehow the presence of water makes it acceptable to bare one's body, almost to the point of nudity. We would like to review swimwear fashions starting around the time Ellen White wrote the following quotation. So she wrote this, Ellen White, in 1855. She says, in these last days, she was talking in this in 1855, please pay attention. She says, in these last days, fashions are shameful and immodest. In 1855, this is what the swimsuits looked like. We don't even dress like this when we go out in general. When you go to the mall, you don't even dress like, and that was for swimming. Women of society in general wore suits like these when swimming. Both the arms and the legs were fully covered, and the form was concealed. Nokuthi umuntu umenjani, the form of the person, the shape of the person.
Bengeke umbone ukuthi umuntu ungumuntu omenjani.
Okay. But not only that, but they had bathing machines, little houses pulled by horses that could be backed into the water so that women don't need to walk on the shore in their wet swimwear.
When you are
wet, your clothes cling onto your body, right? So these were made so that when they are wet, their form is not revealed.
In the show,
they could come from the water and climb right up inside their little changing rooms and put on dry clothes. This way they would avoid any indecent exposure caused by wet clinging clothes. During this time in history, people went to great lengths to make sure they protected the modesty of the woman. You can find photos of these bathing machines from all over the world. The husband and father was the guardian of the modesty of the woman under his care. If you didn't own your own bathing machine, you could buy a ticket to use a public bathing machine during the mid-1800s. Can I read it well?
Yes.
If you didn't own your own bathing machine, you could buy a ticket to use a public bathing machine. During the mid-1800s, society was serious about preserving modesty.
If you look at this lady right here, you feel she's going to the mall.
Mom, boy, can I was fast at the lap? Mom, baby, the man, we are a mall.
The beaches in those days looked nothing like our beaches today. People were covered. You may say something else.
No, if the woman was dressed like this, like this, then clearly you can, because men today also wants to show the body and what to do. So I don't think it's just applied to the woman,
yes.
The men as well.
Because look there,
because you can see
the men are wearing suits. Look at them here.
Because when I look at this, whole picture, this is totally different from what happens today when you go to Durban, wherever.
When we go here, we'll see how things change drastically. I'm trying to cover this very quickly,
yes.
to go very quickly because time is a factor. Alright.
Yeah.
The beaches in those days looked nothing like our beaches today. People were covered, right? Mm-hmm. But changes were soon to take place. No doubt the younger generation considered their parents old-fashioned.
Mm.
New styles of swimwear were developing. The arms became bare.
Manje, ingane zethu, masibona ukuthi yonke into ithe ngokuhamba kwesikhathi kuye kwashintsha. Ingane zethu, mazibuka abazali bazo bagqoka kanje, bese batshela ukuthi nina nabantu abakudala. Manje, izinto ezenzakala manje, umzimba usuvulekile.
So soon, even the older women adopted the new fashion of bare arms when swimming. The new fashion took hold, and no more covered arms were seen in swimwear. In the 1880s and 1890s, during the bicycle fad, Swimming was becoming more popular and women were becoming liberated.
Ngesikhathi ke ngesikhathi sama 1800s kuma 1890s njoba bekwabukunani bahamba ngamabhayisikili abantu bese sebaqala ke bavula imizimba yabo.
The next thing to change was to uncover the lower legs.
Into abaqala ukuyivula kuqala ngokuvula lapha ngaphansi iminyaka enyaweni.
The old bathing machines.
Imilenze.
Yes, the old bathing machines would soon be relics of the past.
Manje ke masesukwenza njalo le mzindlu lezi lapha ebangena kuzo naba ushintsha bese zibonakala kwinto zakusasa.
Azisadingeki. With the abbreviated swimsuits, they weren't really necessary anymore. Now the young ladies would frolic on the beach in their new abbreviated swimsuits. By the early 1900s, the legs and arms became increasingly bare as the material decreased in the swimming costume.
Ngabo 1900s ke kulapho sokubona ke ushintsho ukuthi abantu bese bangaqoqi ngendlela abaqoqa bakhona. Imilenze ivulekile nezingalo zivulekile.
But they still had to deal with those pesky old skirts. These were soon to disappear as well.
Kodwa ke le
iketi
zabe bayaqoqa bese zihamba zinyamalala nazo.
By the way, in 1922, a Washington DC law required bathing suits to be not shorter than 6 inches above the knee. You were arrested if you were a shorter model.
Kuke kwaba nesikhathi lapho ngo 1922 eWashington eAmerica, kwakunomthetho ukuthi umuntu angagqoki into evezayo
enadlula
phezu kwedolo. Bebabopha nokubopha amagqoka njalo.
The fashions were constantly calling for less material in swimwear. Women rejoiced in their new freedom to reveal their bodies.
Manje ke abantu besifazane bese sebajabulile sebakwazi ukuveza imizimba yabo. I wonder why.
Before long, the skirts were removed completely.
Manje neketi lazo bebasifaka ngaphansi bese sebasusile.
The boys took up pastime of girl watching as the young ladies revealed more of their bodies.
Manje ke masesebonakala ke kubonakala imizimba abafana bese sebabuka ke manje sebabona le mizimba emini.
The swimsuits were covering less of the body and revealing more skin.
Manje ke le nto bese basifaka bese singasavali ini imizimba yabo bese seyiveza ni umzimba kakhulu.
The next step was to remove the sleeves.
Manje ke bebaveze ingalo bagcine sebaveza konke ke manje izandla zonke.
Now we start to see photos of bathing beauties as women pose for the camera in their exposed.
Yona nami nibona bese siqala ke sesibona abantu ke manje sebamodela babonisa umzimba wabo omuhle.
The first Miss America contest was in 1920. It was a swimsuit competition. Here are the contestants.
Now ngo 1922 labo kunomthetho khona ukuthi mawuvule umzimba uyaboshwa. Ngo 1920 bese sebakwazi ukwenza futhi ama competition lapho bazobonisa imizimba khona.
But when you look at them, they are not bad still.
Ngoba mababheka bongakafiki esikhathini esikhulu manje.
By the 1920s, the shape of the body was fully revealed in the swimwear.
Ngo 1920, umuntu bese ambona ukuthi umuntu omncane nomzimbeni omkhulu ngendlela bese bagqoka ngayo.
While not all the young ladies wore the swimwear, yet, the influence of those in swimming competition spread quickly.
Ngalo ngazo ikhathi lezo ingane abesifazane abancane bese sebabonisa ke imizimba yabo and futhi bese sebaholela nalabo abanye ukuthi bagqoke ngale ndlela.
As with any fashion, the young ladies had to join in to be in the popular crowd.
Manje nalabo abancane sebabona ukuthi imizimba uyaboniswa uyavezwa manje bese sebajoyina nabo baveze imizimba yabo.
To see young ladies like this on the beach must have been a terrible shock to the elderly who had seen the totally covered swimsuit in the 1880s.
Mawubheka ke ngale zikhathi laba badala mase sebabona ingane laba besifazana abancane sebavuze umzimba kanje. Ngiyakuyazi ukuthi kwakuthusa kakhulu ukubona.
Swimwear sessions continued their decline throughout the
1930s.
Sunbathing became a popular activity since so much skin was now exposed. This graphic shows the progression of swimwear from the 1900s to the
1940s. From 1900 to the 1940s,
first the skirt goes, then the legs, then the sleeves, then continual removal of material. By the 1940s, swimsuits were becoming quite provocative. The popularity of these swimsuits intensified through the movie industry. The first two-piece swimsuits were made available in
1946.
It was in 1946 when the bikini was first introduced by an ungodly man from Paris. What an evil harvest this fashion has reaped.
In 1946,
Mr. Riet, the bikini originator, called it the bikini because he predicted this fashion would cause an atomic eruption in society. It took a while for the bikini to become popular with the masses, but nowadays you can see them at every beach and
poolside.
So in less than 100 years, swimwear fashion had progressed from this to this.
Imagine abona kuti wakala kuphi lapho kuvaleke konke and then njaba sesikuphi manje. So akusana lutho.
This is not progress in God's eyes.
Ayona indlela yokuqhubeka emehlweni kaNkulunkulu.
While not every woman wore a bikini, it became quite fashionable and accepted by society.
Manje ke ukuthi abantu bangagqoki kahle bese bafake nje amabikini kwaba into esejwayelekile.
Can we go to page 48? I'm going to start jumping and my time is actually up.
Yes.
The sad part is Seventh-day Adventist women joined in following the swimwear fashions of the day.
In the swimwear, now
let us seriously consider the implications of such a drastic change in swimwear fashion that took place in just such a short span of time. What did God tell us? We're going to read from Review and Herald, April 8, 1880. I'm going to read this quotation and then I'm going to go right to the end to how we can simplify and dress modestly when we go
somewhere.
The people of God should not imitate the fashions of the world. All who do this will gradually lose that peculiar holy character which should distinguish them as God's people. In these last days, some of the fashions are shameful and immodest. If God's professed people had not greatly departed from Him, They would now be a marked difference between their dress and that of the world. We are living in a time when Earth's inhabitants are growing more and more corrupt. And the line of distinction must be more plain between them and the Israel of God. The curse which falls upon worldlings will fall on God's professed people.
Please
go to page 65 if it shows the
pages.
Um, Okay, 66. Mixed swimming, yes, that's right. So besides that, I'm skipping there because of time. Besides the evils of dressing like that, during Ellen White's time, they would, men and women would not swim on the same beach or on the same section or side. So mixed swimming was unheard of in the early days of our church. As it was becoming popular in society, our leaders spoke out strongly against it.
Please go to page 82.
Yes, there we go. So what do we as Seventh-day Adventist Christians need to do? We need to stop wearing the immodest fashions of the world. We need to cover our bodies modestly when in public. We need to teach modesty to our children when they are young, so they will understand the principles of Christian modesty. There are some acceptable styles available for children. Are there some options for ladies who want to turn away from their worldly fashions in swimwear? Yes. These styles are available for purchase online. While they do not cover as much as they should, they are certainly better than what many Seventh-day Adventist women wear when swimming. While these styles are definitely an improvement over popular swimwear, they still don't match the modesty standards of Ellen White's day. Should God's people on the brink of eternity be contented to be less modest than society as a whole was 150 years ago? Aren't we supposed to manifest the highest standard of purity as we overcome all worldliness, pride, and lust? Then the last picture, can we go to this one? Here is a picture of a California beach in 1905. How society has
fallen.
I encourage the church to go to Save to Serve Ministry. I'll share the link. And then you just watch the series. It's very interesting to see what even Ellen White says. In her day, there was even the American costume. She spoke about the American costume. Even that, when you consider in today's world, it's modest. The American costume that she spoke against in today's day, that is modest compared to what is being worn in our time and day.
Amen. Okay. Let us close our eyes. But here, Heavenly Father, we thank you for your message that you have shared with us. And we know, Lord, that we are guilty. So guilty. We pray that you please, as we hear your message, as you speak to us, may you please convict us and convert us. Help us not to go and harden our hearts today. Help us to come out a new people. I pray and ask all of this. As we continue to hear from thee, please circumcise our ears and our hearts. I pray and ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord, I care not for riches, neither silver nor gold. I would make sure of heaven, I would enter the fold. In the book of thy kingdom, with its pages so fair, tell me, Jesus, my Savior.